So I dig water towers.
Don't get me started on water towers.
Oh, really?
Don't even.
You like water towers too, or? Please, I don't want to feel alone in this. Please say yes.
So when you talk about water towers,
yes,
you have to be specific, because if you live in New York City, water tower means only one thing, and that's the vessel that holds water on the top of your building. But most people, I think, when they hear water tower, they think of the water tower that's in the center of their town.
Oh, that's true.
And if you came at the right time in twilight and you're not quite fully there, it looks like, they all almost look like they landed from Mars.
Right.
Aliens coming down. In fact, during the broadcast of War of the Worlds, there are people thinking it's real, and they were described as having these, you know, and so people were shooting water towers.
Shooting water towers.
Yeah, thinking that that was what was being described. Anyhow, so.
It's kind of cool, actually.
Water towers are interesting because it gives you water pressure without electricity, provided it's full of water.
Right.
All right, but how do you get the water up there? You got to pump it.
Mm.
Water doesn't get there by itself.
Okay, now.
How are you going to get water up to the top of your roof? You got to pump it. That takes electricity. So here's what happens. You pump the water up to the tower. Up, now there's a blackout. You still have water until that tank empties.
Right.
Then you don't have water.
Because you have gravity. As long as you have gravity.
As long as you have, well, gravity to pull the water from behind. Then you have it.
Right.
So basically, if electricity goes out, quickly fill up everything with water. And then it'll be gone, and then you don't have to be stank, you know, the next day.
So now here's the interesting question. If you got to pump the water up to the tower,
right,
why not just pump the water straight to the people's apartments in the building?
Oh, because they might not need it in that moment. Plus, you want enough water at any given instant to accommodate
to everybody.
If everybody wants to take a shower, they can do it.
Right, because all the water is right in this
right
one
in that
tank.
One thing. But therefore, everybody would have to have a pump. And what's the point of that?
Right.
Right. So it has that efficiency, okay?
See, I like water towers even more now.
Now, here's another thing. Have you ever noticed the buckles that go around the water tower that holds them together?
They're like little metal rods.
The metal rods.
All the way around.
Yeah, have you ever noticed those?
Yes, I have.
Have you ever thought about them?
Not really.
Let's split the water tower into three levels.
Okay. Right?
Top, middle, and bottom.
Okay, that would be a good three.
So you can ask, what is the weight of the water of that top third? It's whatever it is.
Right.
Okay? Call it 500 pounds.
500 pounds.
So now I put a little buckle around that.
Right.
Okay? Right at that spot. Let me go to the bottom of that. Now what is the weight of water at that point? Well, it's the top part.
500 plus 500. 500.
It's 1,000 pounds.
1,000 pounds.
Well, if
plus the 500 at the bottom.
I didn't get there yet. Oh. I didn't get there yet.
Sorry.
So if one of these hoops is the right strength to hold 500 pounds.
Right.
Then that one, I need more than one hoop to hold it down here.
Yeah.
I need two.
Right.
If one can hold 500, like two will hold 1,000. Now I'm at the bottom. I have 500. I got 1,500 pounds pressing down at the bottom.
Right.
I need three of those hoops.
Gotcha.
Okay? Go look at the water towers on the tops of buildings. The hoops get closer and closer
as you get to the bottom.
As you get to the bottom. Just because of this fact, the water gets heavy.
Nice. That is more than you ever wanted to know about.
I know it is. It is so too.
And it's so cool as far as I'm concerned.
If they're equally spaced, the person didn't know what they were doing, and you should not move into that building. Because the base of the water tower would not be as structurally sound as the upper portions. And that's, you know, that's where the stuff goes bad.
You better have flood insurance if that happens. Wow, that is so cool.
Water towers. A little bit of physics.
A little bit of physics.
A little bit of electricity.
It's all happening.
Oh, one last thing.
Cool.
If a building is in Manhattan is lower than about six stories, doesn't need a water tower.
All right. Because you can get the water to every apartment just through the regular pressure of a pump?
Yes. No, it's not a pump.
Not a pump.
It's the height of the reservoir that's feeding Manhattan has that elevation above Manhattan.
Gotcha.
So the water
the pressure
falls,
is already there.
The water falls from the reservoir into your faucet over that height. And you know something? The ancient Romans knew that. The aqueduct.
Aqueducts were built on that?
Aqueduct, pieces of which are still standing, was a channel that fed a lake or whatever was their water supply, which is at a higher elevation than Rome. And they scoop up that water, and the water just goes down all by itself. No pump necessary.
Boy, they don't build those aqueducts like they used to.
I know, so it's still standing.
Yep.
We got stuff here falling down that built 10 years ago, and that's up for 2,000 years.
God. Hey.
That just meant the mayor of
Rome
spent too much money building it. If your structures outlive your civilization by 2,000 years,
yeah.
You overbuilt.
You probably overbuilt. That's very funny. All right, there you go. Who knew there was so much to learn about water towers? So next time I wash my hands, I'm going to remember how far that water had to travel into my building. Yes, right. By the way, I never wash my hands. Okay, if you're interested in learning more about hydrostatic pressure, why our everyday appliances are constructed in certain ways, or how we use gravity to our advantage every single day, you should check out Brilliant. Whether you're into superpowers or... well, of course, that's superpowers. Or a lifelong learner, or just somebody who is naturally curious.
Or if you're weirdly into water towers, like he is.
Brilliant will help you master concepts in math, science, and engineering through solving fun, challenging problems. I'm looking through the outside-the-box geometry course. These beautiful geometry problems have such amazing solutions that I want to read the solutions even if I got it correct. It's so much fun, I don't even realize that I'm learning. This is seriously amazing stuff. And as a bonus to StarTalk viewers, the first 78 that go to brilliant.org/StarTalk...
did you pull that number out of?
You know what? Right there. You'll get 20% off an annual subscription, which helps you think like a scientist.
You know where I pulled numbers out of?
Where?
Thin space.
Ooh, snap.
That's thinner than
that's
your thinner.
That's thinner, because there's no atmosphere. You know what I mean? He pulls his number, they go forever. If you want to see more videos from StarTalk, hit the subscribe bar and click the little bell button to get notifications every single time that we upload a video, and give us a like or a comment to express your passion, okay? So make sure that you check us out, and make sure that you check him out, because every time you do, he's going to tell you the same thing.
I would tell you to keep looking up.